Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. This is a lightweight contest over 30 minutes. 6 5-minute rounds, one fall, one submission or a knockout to decide the winner. Presenting and introducing to you in the red corner, just 19 years of age, just turned professional from the amateur ranks, ladies and gentlemen, a nice guy, a nice warm welcome, Mal Asunder! And his opponent this evening, ladies and gentlemen, international lightweight star from Peckham in London, a nice warm welcome, Steve McGray! And your referee, ladies and gentlemen, the number one in the country, Max Wood!
Hello again, Gravel fans. Good afternoon to you and welcome to the Civic Centre here in Aylesbury once again for a freestyle wrestling session. And we start with this lightweight bout, or it was going to be a lightweight bout, but it's unfortunately just got a little overweight. The opponent of Steve Gray, reason, and Mal Sanders of Morden, Surrey, has come in for his first televised bout. As the fair-haired boy, he's a 12-stone-1. Now, this is why Dale Martin Promotions often make a catchweight when they put an experienced fellow like Gray against a comparative new boy like Sanders. But it should quite easily prove to be a very interesting bout indeed. As a preliminary contest, Max Ward is the referee. The packed crowd here waiting anxiously to see how this new boy does, because, as I say, he's never been on television before. Six five-minute rounds, one fall to decide. So Steve Gray in his dark trunks, dark blue trunks there. Dark hair, easily identifiable. Of course, he knows he's up against a comparative novice who only turned pro in August of this year. He's also giving away very nearly a stone and a half to this fair-haired boy from Morden in Surrey. 19 years old, incidentally. Mal Sanders. Yes, he can deliver one of those whips neatly. And Gray, a jump step over toehold to remind him who's governor here. Well, it should be fought to the rules, this bout, because Steve Gray has never fouled in his life, and which has forced him get him out of a situation. But Mal Sanders, in his first televised appearance, was hardly likely to use any dirty tricks or inside moves. So, unlike last Saturday, Max Ward could have a fairly quiet preliminary contest here today.
One, two, three, four.
Climb on a little bit too late with that reverse double leg. Very, very late and too far. He's hoping to do it with his hands now because his legs have gone over the top. No chance. No chance. Well, he's... the body scissors is still holding, and I don't see much point in it from that angle, and nor does he. Half a minute to go, toe and ankle to Sanders. Leg lock to Sanders, and he can hold it until the bell if he wants to. Mal Sanders of Morden, Surrey, 12 stone 1, first time on television, and his 4 years United Amateur Wrestling Club in Stockwell, which is a very famous one. People like Lee Bronson, Dave Bond, Clive Myers came from there. The trainer there, of course, his trainer, Ted Hurdle, very well-known man.
Seconds away, round two.
Round two, 5 to go. One fall decides this bout. And a 4 Nelson to Gray, 4 Nelson to Sanders. Nicely, the double on that one, triple Gray, but he still got caught. Finally. Backhammer right up high between the shoulder blades, Gray. And the feet, watch Gray's feet going behind the knees there. Feet turned outwards to save being lifted any further. This time he missed out. Trying to win. Nearly. Nearly from a bridge. Cross buttock. Gray. Wrist lever. First one side, then switches. Nicely out of that head scissors. There, which may have been worse. Now this time waiting for it. Feet nicely underneath. And so far Max Ward has had nothing to do but count pinfalls and count knockout up to 10. Though he's got nowhere near to 10 so far today. So near his pinfall count. Well, it's a great way out. No chance of getting hold of a limb there. Single finger interlock there. The advantage of the moment, as sound is. Simply because his right hand is on there. The interlock from the top. 20 seconds. Still that finger interlock troubling Gray, but it needn't for more than a second. Steve Gray, I'm sure boxing fans will be interested to know, if they don't already, that his father was the well-known lightweight boxer whose ring name was Fred Steen. Steve Gray from Peckham at 10.5 stone.
Round three.
And Steve is not going to have it all his own way here in these remaining four rounds of this bout, as he must have found out now against this much heavier boy, Mal Sanders. Stone and a half heavier, and although a comparative newcomer to the professional ring, his amateur experience plus Mike Marino's tuition in preparation for the pro ring has been standing him in good stead, obviously, over the last couple of years or so. Mike Marino has started off a lot of these young fellas, and this is one that could go quite a long way, this 19-year-old Mal Sanders. I can't think what better trainer you could have than a man like the mid-heavyweight champion of Great Britain, Mike Marino. Single leg Boston on if Steve Gray wants it. And Steve Gray going to try and match it up, make the whole thing symmetrical, going for the other leg and reaching for the arms for a lean back surfboard if he can do it. There it is, the surfboard. Now submission is on. But Mal Sanders, his first televised appearance, does not want to give this quick. I don't blame him if he can possibly hold on. And he could even have Steve Gray in trouble, and almost did. He got a count of two there on Gray's shoulder press there. Still a chance. Gray proving that one shoulder blade is off the canvas then. Nice moves by both boys then. And much appreciated by this crowd here. Full house here at the Civic Centre here in Aylesbury. The Reg Maxwell Hall. Reg Maxwell, who's the chief executive of Aylesbury Vale District Council, was responsible for this building. He died, unfortunately, though, in June of this year. But in memoriam to Reg Maxwell, this hall. And very, very nice it is, too. Beautifully comfortable seats. And it only holds about 700-odd people, but beautifully tiered. Nicely done. Nicely done, Van Cray. And oh, now trouble for Sanders here. That's the second time he's been caught in a drastic looking submission hold, and this is a great special here. The leg through the figure four leg lock, this bar, and the other leg around the back of the neck. Very tricky one, almost a Zoltan Bostrick on his standing position. Gray manages on the ground. Not quite so effective as it looked from ringside, obviously, because Mel Sanders has not too much trouble to get out of it. Less than a minute now in this third round. For Nelson Gray. Now, you'll never do it with one hand on the shoulder. He's going to get the other shoulder down too. Gives up. And half a minute left. Jump step over toe hold again to Gray. The second or third time he's tried one of these to weaken. Just 5 seconds left. I asked Mel Sanders his hobbies, and one of them is physical culture. The other is soccer. His ambition, since he was 6 years old, he's been watching televised wrestling. He's 19 now, and he's always said, one day I'm going to be up there on that screen in the wrestling ring. Well, this afternoon, he makes it.
Second away, round four.
Round four, three to go. No score, of course, because this is a 1-4 contest. Steve Gray in the dark trunks versus Mel Sanders. Newcomer from Morden, Surrey. Has a weight advantage of a stone and a half, but it evens things up for the experience of Gray. And it's turning out a very, very close contest indeed. It's the first forearm uppercut or smash of any kind of the bout. Oh! Slip, sweat on the arm, forced him to slip. He's going to deliver a posting then. Oh yes, left foot caught him well. Steve Gray's trying to take over a bit. No, nicely done by Sanders. Trouble for Gray. Folding press now. Those arms forward from slipping back. He's got it. There it is. In 1 minute, 25 seconds of round four, the experience of Gray pays off finally, although a magnificent effort by the newcomer, Mel Sanders of Morden. We'll see more of him, that's for sure. Fred Downs, RMC.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Your referee's decision, the winner by the only four required for victory, Steve Gray. And ladies and gentlemen, a nice big hand. Beaten this afternoon, but certainly not disgraced, Mel